from that sad miss. Nope. Hey guys, this is ShadowKirby707, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda, The Wind Waker. In the last part, we completed the Wind Temple, and it'd be Majora and Makaria. Fortunately, we have to leave the Wind Temple. And now our Master Sword is filled with the power, so now it's a true Master Sword. Anyways, in this part, before I begin though, as you can see from my Ruby count, I did get rubies off screen. And most of them, I got them from the rest of the church that I didn't collect. And all of them were 200 rupees. The ones that I collected were number 6, which was in 6 eye wreath. And then 12 was in 5 eye wreath. And then number 14, which was in the Tower of the Gods. 24 in the Fairy Island, Northern Fairy Island. 27, one of those archipelago islands, or Seven Star Isle. I don't know, one of those islands on the right side of the sea map. And then 35 was Isle of Steel. And then 36 was a Bird Peaks Rock, or whatever that place is called. But yeah, all those were 200 rupees. And I also did manage to sell some stuff in my scolds bag. I did sell my joy, or I gave away my joy pendant to Mrs. Marie and got some rupees off of that, which I believe she gave me 100 rupees for, 100 rupees. I sold 19 of those, so she has 60 total. And then I sold my nice cross to Beetle, which was 30 rupees for 5. And then I sold my golden feathers to Beetle, which was 18 for 90 rupees. And then I went to the old man in Windfall, the rich old man, and gave him some of my 13 skull necklaces for 40 rupees. So, yeah, and I found some spare rupees along the way too, so I'm pretty, not exactly where I want to be, but it's pretty close, and I'm pretty sure we'll get more rupees along the way. So, yeah, I got lots of rupees now, so hopefully I don't need to spend too much money along the way. But anyways, aside from that, we're here in Forest Haven, because we are going to start a side quest, a very interesting side quest that can be complicated, at least in this version. But anyways, before we start it, let's talk to the Great Deku Tree and see how he's doing. How are things in the world, Link? As you can see, I am slowly growing older and feebler. It seems only my wisdom is full of vigor lately, or vigor. But that is just the way of life, child, not cause of sadness. If there's anything you wish to know, just ask. Alright, so you can ask him about anything. Let's tell him about the Koroks. The iron Koroks that left the forest. Are you concerned about the little Koroks who left the safety of our forest haven? It is indeed true that there are many islands on the great sea that have grown dark and dangerous. Who knows what perils might await my children. Bleh. I shall mark the places that my Korok children have journeyed to on your sea chart. Alright, so along the way, we did see some Koroks on some islands. And let's also talk about the forest water here. The forest water, so you've learned the secret of our forest haven. The forest water is a mystical and powerful drow that fills the trees with life and vitality. With such water, it would even be possible to return life to be a battered, withered tree. And yet, the forest water is quickly spoiled by the air outside of Forest Haven. Once it leaves the borders of these woods, it will lose its potency after just 20 minutes and become no different from ordinary water. I suppose thanks to such water that this gnarled old tree has been able to live for so many long years. Alright, so the water in Forest Haven is actually very mystical. And also, he marked our map so we get to know where are the Koroks at. If you guys can see very faintly, like little Korok silhouettes on the map, that is where the Koroks are located. Like, there's one located in Shark Island, one is on Needle Rock Isle, Mother Child, and then Star Island, and then one near Eastern Fairy Island, the Private Oasis, and the Cliff Plateau. This one, I'm gonna do that one first, because that one seems to be the longest, but the rest of them are kind of easy and along the way. And you do want to have the Battle of the Gales for this, because there's a lot of shortcuts you can take, so, yeah. But, anyways, so when we start this side quest, you do want to have an empty bottle, and you want to scoop up the mystical water that's in Forest Haven. So, what the Deku Tree said, once you get the mystical water, the timer will start. So you have 20 minutes to complete this side quest, before this water turns to regular water. And if you guys saw the core out there with withered trees, we need to water them with this kind of water. And if you don't hurry up in time, all the trees will be back to be withered, and you have to start up all over in this side quest. So yeah, you can actually check on the time on your menu screen. So you can check how many minutes you have left. So it will tell you how many minutes you have left. And right now we have currently 20 minutes, and I say we go right now. So anyways, I'm pretty sure there'll be some cutting in this episode. I'm not exactly sure, but you do want to rush this. I think in the HD version, the time is a little bit more, I don't know, doing the side quest is a lot more easier. I think in the HD version, they give you more time. I don't know how many, but I think it's a lot more easier in the HD version, if I'm correct. But anyways, to start things off, I am going to sail east to Cliff Plateau, because I find that one to be kind of an obscure location to find that Koroks, so I'm going to head there first. But the rest of them are generally really easy to get to, so I'm going to be really fast and hopefully do this. But I'm pretty sure if you do it fast enough, you have plenty of time left over. I think when I did this in my practice run, oh yeah, by the way, once you get the water, you can see the marks of the Koroks, so you can see them clearly. But yeah, I'm going to try to do this quickly. And I'm pretty sure you get plenty of time as long as you warp to other places, so I'm pretty sure you'll have plenty of time to spare. Anyways, I'm not going to waste any time doing anything, I'm just going to go straight to the island and just get whatever's there. And there is a treasure chart here that you can get, but I'm going to save that for later. I'm not going to bother wasting my time just collecting whatever's in this place. There is like a treasure chest in this place, but I'm not gonna bother getting it. I'm just gonna go in, find the Korok, and get out, and then go on to the next area. So yeah, no time to waste. We are on a rescue mission to rescue the trees. And like my theory for Breath of the Wild, I believe this side quest kind of, in a way, started the Breath of the Wild, like how Breath of the Wild came to be, because my theory is that Breath of the Wild came after Wind Waker, like years later after Wind Waker. So all the trees that we are about to grow are going to turn into the forest that is seen at Breath of the Wild. That's my theory on that. So anyways, we need to navigate through this area, unfortunately. But it shouldn't be a problem. I'm not going to waste any time, so I need my fire arrows real quick. Because if I remember correctly, there's going to be something that we need to burn. So yeah, you have to go find this Korok through this grotto. Crap. No. Shoot. No, get over there. Thank you. Alright, I kind of wasted a little bit of time there, but I think we have plenty of time, hopefully. Hopefully! No, usually I don't have a hard time with this side quest, but still, I like to be quick regardless. Anyways, we fire that, now we can get through. Alright, get through there. There we go, Link. And get my water ready. And no matter how many times you pour out the water, it will still be in your bottle no matter what. So it is unlimited. Anyway, there's a Korok here. I'm not going to have time to talk to you. I'm just going to water this and be on my merry way. Alright, so anyways, with the water from the Forest Haven, it will sprout these trees. But who knows how long they will stay until the water runs out, or it's not magical anymore. But I will stop by for the treasure chest. I mean, it's right here. It's not thing important. I believe it just leads to, you know, a 200 rupee chest, so I might get that later on. But anyways, no time to waste. How many minutes do I have on this? So, 17 and a half minutes. Alright. Let's see. Let's go back to Forest Haven to Private Oasis and get that one along the way. Oh, hello, Chew! Oh, why do you have to waste my time right now? Why do you have to waste my time? Fine, I'll get you real quick. Alright, don't fall in the hole, Link! Alright, oh, you're over there, right? Yes, you are. Alright, I hear the phone ringing, but my mom will get back. Alright, anyways, back to Forest Haven we go. I'm not gonna bother sailing back, I'm just gonna use the warp song as much as possible. And yeah, unfortunately, I think I will kind of cut some parts of this video because it's gonna take forever to sail to these islands. So yeah, this might be one long episode or maybe two parts. Who will see? Depending, because I spent like several minutes in the beginning of this episode just explaining what we're gonna do. But this is the only side quest that we're gonna do for now. There is one more heartbeat that we can get, but I'm not gonna get it just yet. Okay, northwest. Yeah, so this is the second to last heartbeat. There is one more after this, but I think that one will be saved for later on. Because that one also leads to a Triforce chart, which we will get also. But that'll probably be the last one to get, because that one kind of takes a while to get. But yeah, we are almost done with this game, guys. I can't believe it. It feels like I started the Let's Play like a month ago, but it's been several months since this Let's Play has been going on. Oh boy! It's been... I don't know, I feel like this Let's Play went on really fast. Like, it's seriously been going on for really fast. Or, yeah, I can't even talk. It's going by really fast, man. So, yeah. So, as you guys might expect, I might cut some parts of this video just to get to my next destinations. Because it does take a while to travel to next island and find the Korok and all that. So, the Cliff Plateau, I recommend going for that island first, because it does take a while to get through that grotto. So, I recommend going through that island first. And then after that, just go whatever island you feel like you want to go to next. There's no specific order or recommended order which you do, but for me, I recommend just going through Cliff Plateau firstly. Alright, I do have to go around this island. So yeah, anyways, our next stop is Private Oasis, and oh boy, we are going to come back to this island later. Not for the core, but for the Triforce Shard, and I don't like the Triforce Shard in this island. I really don't. It may seem like nothing on the outside, but in the inside of this island, oh boy, I am not looking forward to it. Anyways, the Koroks over here, so let's water... Oh, I don't have my bottle out right. Alright. I'm not sure if you changed the day and night. I'm not sure if that... Okay, that was weird. It popped out. But anyways, I'm not sure if you changed the day and night system in the side quest. I'm not sure if it will affect the... Did I water that? Yes, I did. Right? Not in the show, I did, but I currently did. Whatever. Let's see. Let's go... How about we go north? Let's go to Tower of the Gods and go north. Because that way, I can go to Greyfish Isle and then just sail north and all the way up there. So I could probably do that. So let's go to the Tower of the Gods and sail north. That way, I can spend less time changing the wind direction. Come on, Link. Alright. Alright, so anyways, we're gonna go to Tower of the Gods and sail north. And then go from there. Yeah, I feel like it's gonna be like at least two parts, so yeah. Alright. Okay, now it's green. For some reason, it didn't show up as green for some reason. But yeah. So this episode, I don't know if I want to make this into one big episode. I kind of do, but yet again, I don't know. I probably should make this into one episode, maybe one long episode, but we'll see how this goes. Anyways, let's sail north to the Tower of the Gods and water that one. Yeah, I don't know, maybe I should just turn this into one episode. I don't know. So, half of me saying I should, half of me saying, not really, just save it for the next episode. Because in the next episode, we are going to start Triforce, collecting, so it's not really going to be much difference, really, or importance of having part two of this side quest in the next episode. But yeah, I should probably just cut it here, but yeah, we're sailing north, so we should be there in any moment. Alrighty. Alright, maybe the next one I'll cut the way to Mother and Child, so that way you guys won't have to sit around and just watch me sail island to island. And yet again, another boring side quest. I'm not gonna bother changing from night to day. I'm just gonna keep it the way it is, because I feel like the day and night thing will affect the trees, so no, I don't want to do that. It kind of reminds me of the side quest in Ocarina of Time where you had to get the Goron sword. It kind of reminds me of that. Am I the right island? Yes, I am. Okay. Making sure. I don't want to go in the wrong island. Alright, and get my bottle out. How many minutes do I have left? 14 minutes. I think we should have plenty of time, so I'm not too worried. But we will see. Alright, water that plant or tree, whatever. Alright, so we got that water. Now the next island I want to head to is Grayfish Island, because that way I won't change the wind direction. So we're going to be heading north. Alright. And it's storming over here, but I highly doubt the ghost ship, because I don't think the ghost ship's in this area. Anyways, for Grayfish Island, we are going to sail north, so that way I don't have to change the wind direction. And also, there is a Korok in Grayfish Isle, so the Korok is actually located in that little spiral hill, so just keep an eye on that. Alright, so we're going to sail north, which is really good. Alrighty, we're going to sail north of here. Alrighty, so the Korok is actually located on this little hill right here, so I'm going to stop by Grayfish Island real quick, and then I guess after that I'll cut it to Mother and Child Island, because obviously we can't warp to Mother and Child Island, because we'll be warped inside. And be careful not to roll off this hill, just take your time. Although you do kind of want to rush, but just take your time and don't roll off this hill, because I had done that before. Alright, so anyways, target this tree and just water it. Yeah, I think I still don't know if I want to cut this into two separate videos. Alright, I will see. Ow. Sorry, Link. Sorry for crushing your puny legs. Alright, I think I might just turn this into one episode. We'll see. But anyways, guys, we got that little water. Now our next destination is... Yeah, well, I think it'd be better to sail or go to Tingle Island, because that one's a lot shorter. So, you know what? Yeah, we're gonna go to Tingle Island and just sail northwest and then go north. So yeah, I think that'll be the better way, because it does seem like a long trek to just go three squares north along the way. Yeah, I think it's better just to go to Tingle Island. It's a lot shorter. I don't know. I didn't think about Tingle Island. Oh boy, Tingle Island! We are going to visit that place soon. Alright, anyways, I'm gonna sail northwest and go to Mother and Child Island. I mean, technically you could have done a side quest earlier on, but I was afraid that you'd probably need the hookshot for hook, you know. I don't know, I always thought you need a hookshot for a cliff plateau, but not necessarily. But anyways, guys, I guess I'll meet you guys. Ugh, sharks. You know what, I'm not even gonna bother attacking you, I'm just gonna leave you be. But anyways, guys, I'm gonna cut it here, so I'll meet you guys at Mother and Child Island, and then we'll head to Star Island and from there. So, see you guys then. Shoot! No! No! Stupid shark, no, go away! Alright guys, I am back here in Mother and Child Island, and we have 11 and a half minutes left, so I'm a little worried. I am a little worried. I am very much worried. Anyways, we got that one water. Alright, now we're gonna sail north to Star Island. Oh boy, we're almost done, guys. We're halfway done. Halfway done. Oh boy, okay. So we're gonna sail north, and yes, that shark did chase me along the way, unfortunately with that whirlwind. Alright, let me check my time real quick. Yeah, 11 and a half minutes. Alright, King of Red Lions, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up! We don't have time, I feel like I'm running out of time. Alrighty, so anyways, we're gonna sail north to Star Island. Oh shoot, do I have that shark following me? I think I do, right? I better not. I felt like I did. Hopefully not. Yeah, cool, I like how you see the Windfall Island from here. Oh shoot, I see that shark! I see that shark in the distance, guys. Right over there. That shark is right there. He's gonna come by, I just know it. He's gonna surprise. Oh, he's coming. He's coming. Yep, there he is. He was swimming far away, but thankfully, hopefully, he won't attack me. Yeah, I think this might be a long episode, guys. Sorry if it is, but I kind of want to make this into one big episode. Kind of. I don't really want to, but yeah, I spend so much time at the beginning of this episode that explaining things, so that's why it's a little bit longer. Screw the shark! Screw the frickin' shark! No! Go away, shark! No! Go away, go away! Go away, shark! Oh my god. I did not expect to jump on that shark, crap. Okay, go away, shark, go away. We don't like you guys. You guys are the worst. Oh crap, now we got bomb barrels. Oh! Okay, thank you for bumping into the bomb barrel. Alright, get that 10 rupee, why not? Alright. Alright, stop by this island, and yeah. I'm pretty sure we'll make it as long as I don't waste time. Alright. Alright, let's water this plant. Or tree. Alrighty. Water this plant. There we go. Alright, we got 3 more islands left, I think. How many do we have? Okay, 2 more islands. Awesome. Let's go to Alstead and sail northeast. Where's my boat? Right? Boat? Crap. I can't find my boat now. There you are. Alright, now let's try wine. Yay! Alright. No time to waste. Let's sail to Alstead and to northeast. Yeah, I think we got this. I think we got this. I'm feeling pretty confident, so I think we got this. Alrighty, sail to Alstead and sail northeast, and then, yeah, I think we'll be pretty much done. Oh my gosh. That shark was kind of annoying me. It doesn't help that the creepy music plays while you're being chased by that shark. It doesn't help at all. Alright, so let's sail northeast. So, yeah, I'm pretty confident that we'll get this side quest done in one try. I don't know if a lot of people had trouble with this. I'm pretty sure there are some people that had trouble with this, but I mean, it's not that bad as long as you rush. I mean, it kind of sucks if you have to rush this. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Ooh, less than 10 minutes. Okay, we better hurry. I feel like I'm gonna barely get this side quest done. So, you better hurry. Run along, Link, or sail, I should say. Sail! Alright, so we're on our way to Shark Island, which at one point did have the cyclone, but thankfully we had the Battle of the Gale, so we don't have to worry about any cyclones. And also, since we have all items now, we can potentially get what's over in this island, but I feel like it's just a treasure chart containing 200 rupees, and I really don't need it. So, yeah, I'm not gonna worry about that. I don't remember where the Koroks is at on Shark Island, to be honest, so... we got, hopefully, plenty of time to search for this Korok, but it shouldn't be that hard. I'm pretty sure he's somewhere on Shark Island. And the name Shark Island, I don't know why, but whenever I think of Shark Island, I feel like it's gonna be an island filled with sharks surrounding this island. That's what I was thinking, but... No, it's not. Alright, well, where are you, Korok? I think I see you. Right over there. Yep, I see you. I think that's you. Are you over here? Yes, you are! Alright, awesome. Alright, one more tree to water and then that'll be it. Oh my gosh, this is going on very long. A long episode. Sorry guys for this long episode, but it's... Crap. Am I on the wrong side? Oh, crap. Oh! Kangaroo Lions, help! Kangaroo Lions, help! Thank you. Alright, anyways, one last island to go to. Let's go to Greyfish Island and sail southwest. Oh boy! Yeah, this is gonna be a long episode. I'm not really a big fan of, like, long episodes. I usually go at least 20 minutes. The most I will do is 22 minutes. But after that, you're pushing it. You're pushing it. But, I mean, it's kind of fitting just to make this into one episode. Just get it done and over with, so... Yeah. But we should be done with this side quest in no time. Alright, anyways, let's sail southwest. You know, I could just cut some parts out. If I had gel, that's fine, but I could have cut this part out just to make this video a little... What am I doing? I could have just cut some part of this video just to make it shorter, but we'll see. Nah, I probably won't. Unless if I don't talk for a while, then maybe perhaps I will cut it. Anyway, southwest, I believe it's the island that we need to go to, right? Yes, Needle Rock Island. Good. Oh yeah, that's that one island with their birds flying around. Yeah. Alright, so let's head to Needle Rock Island, and then that'll be it for this episode. Oh boy. Jeez Louise. I'm not looking forward to the next episode, though. I am not looking forward to the next episode, because the next episode we're going to start Triforce hunting. At least I'm going to start with the least favorite place that I'm not looking forward to, which is Private Oasis. Not looking forward to that. Not really. I'm not looking forward to that one, but I might as well get that one out of the way, because I hate that Triforce chart. Even though it's simple, but I hate it. I hate it. Alright, so we're almost there to the Needle Rock Island. And once we get our reward, I'm just gonna end it off there. And I'll meet you guys. I guess I'll meet you guys in Private Oasis just to start off there. Because the next episode, we're just immediately gonna start with Triforce chart hunting. And speaking of which, there is one on this island, but I'm not gonna get it just yet. It's right there. It's just pretty much a bunch of cannon ships, and we can destroy them, but I'm gonna wait until later. And it's raining here. Those birds better not attack me, I swear. If they literally scare me, then I'm gonna be pissed. Alright, anyways, we should have plenty of time. How many minutes do we have left on that water? Oh, 6.5 minutes. We got plenty of time. Alright, just in case if those birds just come chasing after me, I'm gonna have my boomerang out with me. Hopefully not. Alrighty, anyways. One last journey to water! Alright, here goes nothing. Alright, so we water this tree, and behold, it has come to life! Yay! And with that, the tree has grown and it has a face. And with that, it gives us a heart piece. And this will make heart piece number 43. So we need one more to fill all of our hearts. Just one more, guys. Just one more. Alright, so anyways, guys, we completed this side quest, and I think I'll call it an episode here. So next time on The Legend of Zelda, The Wind Waker, we're going to officially start with our Triforce hunting. Yep. And we're going to go to Private Oasis. Oh my gosh, I'm not looking forward to it. Anyways, I'll see you guys there. So, this is Shama Kirby 707. Say bye!